Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. The corridors have fallen silent at a school in Hornchurch after old-fashioned rules were brought back in a bid to combat bad behaviour. Pupils at the Albany School have been banned from speaking as they move in orderly lines between lessons. The playground also falls silent at the end of break as children line up on the playground to head to class. But teachers, who have to thank the students for obeying the rules, have said it has already sparked improvements. Head teacher Val Masson spent 11 years as a humanities teacher at the school in Havering, East London, before becoming head in September 2016. Three new rules have been brought in to improve behaviour at the Albany School in Hornchurch. In 2015, the school was graded as requiring improvements by school's watchdog Ofsted. The head decided to revive stricter methods of teaching and said that after introducing her silent rules, the number of pupils in isolation for poor behaviour halved in just a month. She said, "There are several reasons why we did it. We wanted a calm and academic atmosphere like a high-end institution. The second reason is that we believe in equality for all, so even your meekest, most underconfident child should be given the space to grow." Students at the Albany School in East London are being made to walk silently between classes, because the head teacher says it calms them down. And the third thing is that silence creates a very mutually respectful relationship between students and staff. It encourages a no-raised voices environment. I don't agree with raising voices to children, and usually staff only need to do that if there is a lot of noise. As part of the new regime at the school, students from years 7, 8 and 9 are made to queue silently in the playground three times a day, before school, and after morning and lunch break. Teachers then thank them for participating and for their hard work. Year 10 students, who are studying for their GCSEs, will now have to stay an extra hour after school 4 days a week to work without speaking, from September, under the new regime. Mrs. Masson, 51, said, "Students have 3 minutes to queue and they line up in their form group." Val Masson, head teacher of Albany School, where children have enforced silent time. The former humanities teacher wants to improve behaviour at the school, which in 2015 was told by Ofsted it requires improvement. When the second bell goes, they're expected to fall silent. Then a senior staff member or a head of year, including myself, will encourage them to enjoy and get the most out of their next lesson. We take the time to praise them for high standards of things like uniform and punctuality. However, not everyone is happy with the changes. A parent who contacted Mail Online but asked not to be named said she is not impressed with the rule changes, while insisting the school is still failing to tackle bad behavior. She said, "Parents are not happy, so I'm not sure why they are saying we are. Nobody told us about the changes. My child just came home in June at the end of last term and told me about it. I have had so many issues with them, I don't want to send her back there. My child has been bullied for months and they've done nothing about it." The parent said the rule was being rolled out across the academy, and was not just specific to the school, nor was it the school's initiative. Mrs. Masson said the scheme was divisive when it was first suggested in meetings with other members of staff, but she says staff members have noticed a marked improvement in how calm many pupils are. The school has just under 900 pupils and over a third receive free school meals. She added, "We've seen far fewer lessons starting late. Regularly lessons are starting way before the late bell. Before we did this, students were still arriving at lessons then, but now they're beginning on average 3 minutes earlier. If you multiply that, it's 15 minutes extra teaching a day. When students don't settle, we have a relocation system that sees them sent to another classroom to settle down." What are the new rules at the Albany School? Silence in the corridors between classes. The students must move in orderly lines and in silence. This is so they remain calm and go into their next lessons ready to learn. Playground lines before, after and during school. Pupils must form silent queues in the playground. Playing will end and before moving on, the children must be quiet and lined up. After school studying from September, the pupils in year 10 will have an extra hour added to their school day, 4 days per week. This will be for silent studying. That system has almost reduced to zero. We almost get no relocations anymore, and that's because a lot of distraction was happening at the beginning of the lessons, and it was the success of the scheme that spurred on Mrs. Masson to push the boundaries by asking year 10 students to stay an hour later from next year. She said students would be expected to carry out their extra work without speaking. Year 10 student Ronnie Brooks, 15, who is studying for 7 GCSEs, said he supported the stricter rules. He said, "It's completely changed the school, it's made it so much calmer. It used to be quite boisterous when you walk into lessons and now it's very calm, everyone is mentally prepared," and fellow pupil Olivia Hazel, 15, agreed, adding, "I think it's really good to be honest. When you walk to lessons, you can remain focused on your work because you're already in the calm mindset. It's helped a lot of people. When you walk into lessons, you aren't getting pushed around or anything. It makes studying for my GCSEs a lot easier. Encouraging pupils to keep noise to a minimum has substantial benefits," said Dr. Helen Lees, the author of Silence in Schools. Students in Year 10 will be made to stay for an hour after school 4 days per week when the new school year begins. She said, "It's a very bold experiment and it sounds amazing. From everything I've read on the uses of silence in schools, it's stirred to work and have the effects that it's having. The key to it is regularity. It's the fact that these students are expecting it and they are dwelling in the silence because they know it has a purpose. It's part of the school environment and in general, they are happy to take part in it." Jeff Barton, General Secretary of the Association of School and College Leaders, praised the scheme. He said, "Schools use a range of techniques to encourage orderly behavior and create a climate for learning. Head teachers work with the school community, including governors and parents, to establish the approaches which work best for their school and build a shared commitment towards the expected standards. Short periods of silence can encourage reflection and calmness in an age which is often noisy and frenetic."